Hey everyone, we finally got a day that's not raining for once. If anybody has been in the Indiana and Ohio area, you know how bad the flooding has been. It's been crazy lately. So while we have a nice day, I hurry up and got the Lincoln outside on the trailer. And today we're going to be prebending the rear frame on this car. So quickly, let's talk about the basics to unibodies and prebending. If you haven't heard before, my usual setup for most compacts is to remove the back bumper, tuck the trunk, and prebend the rear. I do this because that is pretty much the 100% safest way to guarantee your trunk will go up and pack in by having the trunk lid and the frame prebent. I take the bumpers off because I don't want that much strength going to my frame rails and pushing them down. I'd rather the body just smash into a big old ball. Certain compact cars you can leave the bumper on in the back. It depends on the car itself. Any car that is known to plow in the back, or if you don't know, then remove the back bumper. So this car is basically a Ford Taurus. And they plow very bad if you know anything about them in the back. So, the first gen Taurus here, style, we will be removing the bumper and pre-bending it. I do have one side already pre-bent, and I just now started doing the other side. So I'm going to show you this side as it bends. If you look here, on the frame of the side that has already bent, you can see my notch, and you can see where it started to pinch shut. That notch used to be as big as that one. So you know it's bent a lot. And I'll hold the camera straight here if you see my frame rail. Camera is currently level and the frame rail is on an angle. And just to give you guys a measurement number, I did take the tape measure and I measured from the bottom of this towing hook to the bottom of the trailer there. And the factory setting was 13.5 inches. After I pre-bent it, we were sitting at 16 inches from the bottom there to the trailer. So that's a 2.5 inch lift I did on the rear frame of this car. And here is a shot inside the car. So you can see the floor. And no, I did not cut a hole in the trunk floor. That hole opened up on its own. All I did was cut my slice that I always cut in the floor of the trunk, and when I jacked up, it separates that. So when I put this car back in the garage later this week, I will put a jack under the floor of this donut spare tire compartment, and I will pull that up into the car. I'll put a jack on it, shove it way in the car. But yes, it is coming together very nicely right now. It's starting to pinch shut, and it'll be nice and strong. It'll be solid, and it will be pre-bent. So the easiest way that I do this on my compact cars, I've tried several different methods now. This is by far the number one easiest method I've ever found. I've tried taking a chain and wrapping it around my trailer, running it over the top of my trunk and then down to the other side of the trailer. I tried putting it through the windows and down. None of that seems to really work. Instead, when I jack up, it just bends the body of the car and pushes it down instead of bending the frame of the car. So instead, to get a more direct bend exactly where I want it, I come inside the car here and I just pop a hole in the floor of the car next. Right there is my notch. Back there is my hole I popped in the floor, and there's the other hole. I run a chain through that hole over the frame, down through that hole, and then I wrap it around the support beam of my trailer. So now when I jack up way back here on the tip of my frame and jack up, the weakest point is going to be my notch. And that chain's going to hold it down back there behind the notch. So right here, we're ready to start on this side. I have my holes popped through on both sides of the frame. I have the chain wrapped around it. The chain is down here around the frame. I have the chain bolted together right there. It's nice and tight. You always want is to get these chains as tight as possible. Every little bit, every centimeter makes a difference on these chains. The more tighter this chain is, the less space you're going to waste jacking up on your jack. When you try to lift the car up and pre-bend the frame, all that effort will go straight into the frame instead of tightening that chain out tighter. So I got the car nice and snug right now. You see I used a little bit of my bottle jack space right here. We're not halfway there, but we're getting there on the bottle jack length. And that was just the slackness in the chain to get it tight. So I'm going to start cranking up on this. And this is literally all you do, guys. I got blocks of wood down on my frame itself. I try to do this where there's a cross beam to support the weight of the bottle jack. This is my new bottle jack, which is a 12-ton bottle jack. Makes a huge difference if you have a strong bottle jack to do this. Some other people will use other styles of jacks to do this. I personally love bottle jacks. They seem to be the easiest to shove underneath a frame and brace and just crank up on. So now I'm starting to do this, and I don't know if you can see it bending yet. I can hear the frame crinkling as it's starting to get weak. And this bottle jack moves real little bit at a time. So we're slowly getting it up there. Oh, there we heard some noise. It's starting to bend now. I can see the frame itself starting to tilt. See right there, it's starting to go slightly upwards. It does take a bit of work to get this. I mean, this car is a clean car, so. But once you get it to start folding at the notch, it'll go very fast. There, now it's starting to go. Now it's cranking. That notch is getting smaller and smaller as we crank on this thing. And there we go, our jack is maxed out. As you can tell, it won't go any higher. I had the threads already screwed all the way up just to get the height set, and look at our frame. See the tilt we have going on right now? Let's look at it from the inside. Oh yeah, look at that. Take my hammer out of the way. You can see the floor here. Definitely starting to get a tilt to it. It's not as steep as the other side yet. The other side, I actually pulled it down, undid the bottle jack after I maxed it out, retightened my chain, because now I have some slack in my chain. Because this bent up, I can now undo my jack, it'll lower the jack down, I'll retighten my chain and suck it up tight against the floor again, then I'll reset my jack and jack it all the way up again. And after that second full cycle on the bottle jack, it should be up just as far as this one, because that one took two full cycles. So let's check our frame out right now, make sure we don't have any damage to the frame. We don't want it to start tearing anything crazy. If you ever see your frame start to tear, it's probably a good sign to stop, or you're going to make it worse. You can see the notch there starting to pinch shut, definitely a lot smaller than what it was. And same thing on this side, I believe it just pinching shut. On that side. Also, you can see at the floor here, our gaps are very close together. They're not overlapping. This side over here, the metal actually started overlapping where I had cut out. So we know it's definitely not bent as much. So we're gonna relieve pressure off of the jack. And when you do this, some of the frame is going to bend back down just from the weight of the car. And metal has what is called memory. It remembers where it was bent at before this. And it's gonna try to go back to that position. So it's just slowly bring it down. You notice the frame is trying to straighten itself back out. You always want to overbend when you pre-bend a trunk. Overbend it slightly where you would want it at. That's like when you relieve the pressure off the jack, it actually brings the frame slightly down and you have it set where you want it. All right, so we just pop the jack down there. Pull it out. I'm gonna push the rest of this thing down. There, my jack is all the way in. This part is all the way unscrewed. We're going to retighten the bottle jack down here. And we're gonna stick it back under here. Now you'll notice, I'll show you the height difference. Look at that, the bottle jack is actually not even hitting the frame. That's how much we moved the frame, that big gap, because that bottle jack was originally touching the frame. Just from cranking it one time, we brought it up that much. So, there you guys have it. That's the basics to pre-bending a trunk. I showed you how to get started. Hopefully you could follow from there and finish up yourself. I'm gonna go get another block of wood for my garage so I can get this jack a little bit higher up to pre-bend it some more. And then this trunk will be pretty much done. One last word of advice before I go, guys. You'll notice my trunk lid is actually popped up in the air right now like a normal trunk, even though it was tucked. That is because I did not remove the trunk springs up underneath there. those tension bars, I cut them out last before I wire my trunk lid shut. And the reason I do that is so when I'm pre-bending it right now, that trunk lid will stay up in the air on its own out of my way. And it helps a lot when you're trying to work on the trunk. So, just a word of advice, never cut those tension bars until you are ready 100% to seal that trunk lid shut. All right, guys, hopefully you get some good luck and good results from pre-bending your trunks this way. If you have any other questions or advice on how you do it that works better, always leave a comment below the video. And stay tuned, it's almost time to start painting this car.